God has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in Him. I want to thank God for this day. I want to thank God for this hour. And it's exciting. It's a privilege to be a partaker of the kingdom of God. And that's what we are here to do, together as co-laborers of the kingdom. With me today, I have with me a young man that is passionate, he's got passion for the kingdom of God, by the name Dr. Chudi. Please say something about yourself and the ministry God has given you to all our viewers so that they can know who you are and where you are coming from. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much, Pastor David. I'm very glad to be here and to share this brief exposition and talk concerning the kingdom of God with you. My name is Dr. Chudi Esenwa. I'm the administrator of Grace Evangelistic Ministries in the UK. I'm based in Leyden, Basildon, Essex. And it is a teaching ministry. I'm not a pastor, so there's no church anywhere, but it's a teaching ministry, and I try to encourage all my hearers to actually study, just like Brother Paul, exhorted and instructed or encouraged Timothy to study to show himself approved, because study of God's word is very critical for our understanding. For the Bible says, "The truth you know will set you free," and that is the basic or the core thing our great evangelistic ministry does, is to try to encourage, to promote, to, as it were, to ginger up the saints of God to study the word for themselves, just like the Berean Christians, so that they will know what scriptures is saying, and they will not be fooled or carried by every wind of doctrine. That's basically what great evangelistic ministry is.
Praise the Lord, people of God. I want you to know that at this end time, the Bible says people are going to have itchy ears. And I also want you to know that the same scripture makes it known unto us that we all need to study to show ourselves approved unto God. Whether you are a pastor, whether you are a teacher, whether you are an apostle, whatever your calling is, whether you are just like one of my friends would say, ordinary member of the body of Christ, whether that is your position, the Bible states clearly, study to show yourself approved unto God. A workman, see, that is the qualification of us all. A workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Dr. Chudi, we're going to go into the word of God. And I believe that when we talk about the kingdom, there is more to it than what we see. It's just that a lot of us do not take the time to search deep into the Bible. I, as a person, I know that from Genesis to Revelation, there is only one place that the scripture is referring us to, which is the kingdom of the Most High. We are representing that kingdom on the face of the earth. But I'd like us to go into the book of Acts. And I know that there are three major keys in the book of Acts. We can see the name Jesus in the book of Acts. We can see the Holy Spirit in the book of Acts. And likewise, we can see prayer in the book of Acts, which at the end of the day gave the apostles the enablement by the power of the Holy Ghost, by the name that is above every other name, and the ability for them to pray in that name, and also to pray in the Holy Ghost. We see enablement that they were unstoppable when it comes to the kingdom. I believe God has left something in your heart to share together in the book of Acts. Please, there is no protocol. I just want us to talk about the kingdom of God. The language of John the Baptist is, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. The language of Jesus is, there are parables that he gave about the kingdom. And every prophet that has been sent also refers to the kingdom. So I want us to start from the book of Acts. As the Spirit of the Lord is laying upon your heart, why not let's share it together, what the church is supposed to be, what the church ought to do, what the church not ought to do, and above all, the representative of the kingdom. That's what we are. Over to you, sir. Let's talk about the kingdom.
Yes, the kingdom of God. In fact, that is the central theme of our Lord Jesus Christ throughout his 3.5 year ministry. And even when he was crucified, he died and he was buried and he rose again on the third day, we were told in the book of Acts, chapter 1, verse 3, that even Jesus, before he finally ascended into heaven, for 40 days after the resurrection, he showed himself. And what was he showing himself for? Not to just tell people, oh, look at me, look at the nails. He was telling them things pertaining to the kingdom of God. In fact, the book of Acts, yes, chapter 1, verse 3, says, to whom also he showed himself alive after his passion, by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days, and speaking of the things pertaining
to the kingdom of God.
That was the central theme for 3.5 years. Even for 40 days after the resurrection, Jesus Christ still saw it necessary, deemed it necessary to finalize, as it were, the things concerning the kingdom of God, because that is the central thing. And until the church comes back to that same message, I'm sorry to say, the church will still be going around in circles. In fact, it's with grieving heart I say this, that the church needs to look into this and preach the kingdom of God, and not some other gospels that we are hearing these days, the gospel of...
Let me pause you before we go further. You've just mentioned something about the church. When we look closely in the scripture, we realize that the church is not just anybody. It's the call out ones. When Christ called, the Bible says we are translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of his dear son. So when that translation takes place, and God perfect that, you know, the crossover, what exactly is the assignment given to every member of the body, which is the church today? If you want to lay emphasis on that before we go further.
Yes, Jesus himself said it, that the what we were supposed to do was actually to go out in the world to preach. And in fact, it is written in Matthew, in the book of Matthew, he said there is a message we need to preach, and that's the kingdom of heaven, or the kingdom of God, and that is when the end will come. We need to preach it as a witness, he said, before the end will come. And unfortunately, like I said earlier on, yes, the church has not preached that message, and the end will not come. Jesus will not come back until that message, the message of the gospel of the kingdom, is preached. In the book of Matthew, he said so. It's written very clearly there, and like I said earlier, we have not started preaching that message yet.
Okay, in other words, that shows the church is not yet on the right track, if I get what you're saying right.
Yes.
Because when we look at the early days, in the times of the apostle, what the church is there, is there the same church that we have today? Because one thing that I have seen in the life of the apostles, I do not see competition. I see that they complement one another. Though I see persecution, which the church that is of this day is also in different part of the in different part of the countries, in some part of Asia, we see how people that are believers are being persecuted. In some part of Africa, we also see that people are being persecuted because they are Christ-like people. They believe in Christ. But let's look at what is the impact and the ability of the Holy Spirit in the days of the apostles that makes them to be what they are concerning the kingdom. Let's look into that one. Because I see in the book of Acts chapter 2, Christ said to them in chapter 1 that you guys need to stay here. You guys need to stay here until the power comes. Says, you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you, which I believe is a mandatory thing for every child of God to have the power. The Bible says the same Christ that came, that has gone, is the same Christ that lives in the inside of us. The Bible says greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. When we look at he that is in the world, we know that he's not, because Christ has come and Christ has gone. But what do I want us to see is the power of the Holy Ghost in enablement of the kingdom, preaching the kingdom despite the fact that there are opposition. Against all odds, is the church on track in terms of the power of the Holy Ghost today, or we are still dilly-dally? What have you got to say about that, sir?
Well, from what I can see and from what scriptures has, you know, the book of Acts has shown us, is that the church has not started with the right message.
Hmm.
And that is a big problem. The real message is the kingdom of God. That is what we were instructed to preach, the kingdom of God. And until we start to preach the kingdom of God, heaven is not committed to fully back us as it backed the disciples in the book of Acts. I remember one of the disciples, that is Simon, when he went to Samaria.
Yes.
He was able to turn a town, one single man, turn a town upside down.
Wow.
Why? It is recorded explicitly in the book of Acts that he was preaching concerning the kingdom of God.
Mm-hmm.
That is because he went with the right message. So heaven backed him up, you know, with that message. And heaven was able to confirm it with signs and wonders.
Mm-hmm.
But nowadays, since a lot of the body of Christ is yet to apprehend or comprehend that scripture, that message, the theme of the gospel, heaven is not that committed to backing them with signs and wonders. And that is why, unfortunately, and I say with a grieving heart, we are not able to be like what Jesus said we should be. That means the salt of the earth, the light of the world. And that is why you see what we have today, churches or ministries trying to cajole some people or cajole people with some funny programs, and we are not getting any impact. In fact, we are not making any impact at all. In fact, during the week, a man of God said it. He said, if some churches or ministries should pack up shop and close up where they are today, the community where they are operating will not even notice they were gone.
Mm.
Why? Because they are not making any impact.
Mm.
And that is why. But in the book of Acts, we saw it. It's recorded in Philip's, that is Acts chapter 8, verse 12. We saw what Philip did. Philip, that's Acts chapter 8, verse 12. But when they believed Philip preaching the things concerning the kingdom of God and the name of Jesus Christ, they were baptized, both men and women. If we read the whole of Acts chapter 8, you see what Philip did there. He turned Samaria upside down and he was preaching the kingdom. He was not preaching prosperity. He was not preaching deliverance. He was not preaching
breakthroughs, breakfalls.
He was not preaching faith.
Mm.
He preached the central theme Jesus preached,
Christ,
the kingdom of God.